the show. And joining us is the co-author of our co-cookbook, Rebel Homemaker. It's Chef Pilar Valdez. All right. Pilar and I are here to make Molly a delicious meal out of our new book.
Mm-hmm. Speaking of your new book, I have a little something for you. I heard you haven't seen your new book yet.
We have not like the real version.
My lord.
Here's your baby.
This is the real thing. This is a moment. You two. This is your moment. Take your moment. This is your moment.
How about that this memory will forever be with you, Molly?
Oh my God.
Oh my gosh. Like, here's a page from our book. It says breakfast.
And this is real happening.
When it's alive. It's been crowning for so long.
Oh my God. It's beautiful.
Oh my gosh. Okay. See, here you can see. Oh, okay.
I'm just going to sit down.
This is so crazy. So it's, I mean, here's pictures of Pilar. This book was made with so much love and just so cool. Okay. It's so weird. All right. Well, we still have to cook. I'm just going to, by the way, how about that? Just resting it right there in our kitchen. That feels very surreal. Anyway. We are going to make Molly a beautiful recipe, actually, from our book. And Pilar, let's tell her what we're making.
All right. The pasta al limon with peas.
I love peas and pasta.
So good. Exactly. Two of your favorite ingredients, Drew. So the first thing we're going to do, actually, this is some boiling water over here.
Do I get to start eating it immediately?
Oh, yeah.
Can I eat
yeah,
it
just
while
go
you're
in.
Cooking
yeah.
It?
So we've got boiling salted water, and we're going to just drop in, that's 8 ounces of bucatini. And we're going to do the sauce, and basically when the pasta is done, your sauce is probably going to be ready. So you ready, Drew?
For sure, yes.
We're starting off with some butter. I'm like, I can't believe the book is behind this.
I know. I know.
Oh, my God. Okay.
When they asked me to be part of this moment, I was like, this is such a personal moment. I cried when I first saw my first book.
We'll get there.
I can see you're tearing up. I'm ready to cry, and it's not even my book. I mean, I was like, are you sure?
Here's also, like, a little backstory for the book. Pilar and I met, I don't know, was it 3-4 years ago? Mm-hmm. I was going through a divorce. I was in a rental. I didn't know where my life was supposed to go. I didn't have a job. My whole life had basically crashed. And I was really lost and confused, and I met Pilar. And I would talk her about this cookbook collection I had and how much I love cookbooks. There wasn't one cookbook in the kitchen because it was a rental apartment. And we just started making recipes and talking about spices and travel and kind of bonded over the love of food. And it distracted me at such a difficult time of my life. And so the cookbook is very meaningful, and it is based on friendship, and it is based on life. And my life also took off when I met Pilar. So it's a real love letter.
For sure. I feel, oh my God. I'm like, I have no words. I'm literally like, I think I'm supposed to put the garlic in here. But
garlic
in the butter. I'm going to carry on. This is how life goes, right?
It smells incredible.
It smells incredible. I'm about to start crying, but that's okay.
Wouldn't be the first time.
We'll all cry and eat pasta.
So we got the butter.
Yep.
We've got garlic. And you want to add a little bit of lemon juice, and you're going to swish that around and give it a good stir. And what that does is it starts to build a really lovely sauce.
Okay.
Drew, we're going to add some pasta water.
Mm.
All right. So, Drew, we've got your pasta water in there, lemon and garlic. And then as soon as your pasta noodles have boiled, we're going to drop that into the pan, give that a good toss, little swirl. And then, Drew, I think on your side, we have a little bit of mascarpone cheese.
It's my favorite ingredient
I was
pasta.
Wondering what the creaminess was in here.
It's a mascarpone, which is really lovely. It's an Italian soft cheese. And you're going to give that a stir. I think I'm getting it all over myself. Mm-hmm. I realized that I should have added the peas earlier on, but, you know.
Mm-hmm. Just add that little pop and texture
yep.
that I think is missing okay. in a plain pasta with a sauce.
All right, love. The last thing you're going to do is add a little bit of Parmesan. You're going to do 1 tablespoon, and then we'll save the rest, you know, when we're plaking up. The one thing that I will say about the pasta sauce is that you do want it to feel really saucy and wet, kind of like how it is right now, because especially with sauces that are like cream based, the noodles are gonna sit and absorb. And then just to finish, after you plated, you finish off with a little more Parmesan, of course, and a little more lemon zest.
I'm obsessed with this pasta. This is so good.
Shall we taste?
Yeah. More reason to eat it, please.
Cheers.
Cheers.
Congratulations.
Congratulations. Mm.
It's a girl.
Thank you so much, Molly.
Congratulations. The book is beautiful. The pasta is amazing.
Mm-hmm.
I'm so excited for you.
I'm sorry. I'm a discover. It's so good.
It's a pasta day. It's a pasta day.
Before we go, Molly, we have a gift for you, not knowing you had such a special one for us.
It's like beyond this bowl of pasta, because this
it is,
feels like a gift.
Oh, God, I know, it's taking everything in me not to shove. It's just for your little one, your newest little one.
Oh, my gosh, this is thank you. This is the cutest thing I have ever seen.
Oh, chef's hat
and a little apron. Oh, my gosh.
Thank you, Molly, so much.
Thank you, Drew. Thank you, Pilar.
All right. Be sure to check out season 6 of Molly's show, Girl Meets Farm, airing now on the Food Network. And we will be right back as I shovel.